Animals, eggs and sperm cells are produced by different individuals, females and males. There are, however, tens of thousands of species in which females and males are not separated. In these animals, eggs and sperm are produced by the same individuals and they are called hermaphrodites. Interestingly, the majority of hermaphrodites do not self-fertilize. The largest and most significant group of hermaphrodites belongs to mollusks. We are visiting now Professor Joseph Heller and his large mollusk collection at the Hebrew University of Jerusalem to learn more about this remarkable phenomenon.
Hermaphroditism is very widespread among animals. It is most common among mollusks. Hermaphroditism goes with a cost because each individual has to develop both a male and a female system. It has been speculated that the great advantage of hermaphroditism is that in populations in which there is a very low density, the chance meeting of two individuals of the same species will always result in reproduction, in mating, and hopefully in reproduction. Now, to examine this, we carried out a survey of all literature of the entire phylum of mollusks to see in which group there are hermaphrodites and in which there are not. All the land snails, the pulmonates, many of the freshwater snails, some of the marine snails, and all marine slugs. It would be absurd to claim that everywhere all these populations have a low density. Many of them have high densities, others have low densities. These data suggest that the occurrence of hermaphroditism is a phylogenetic constraint. Once upon a time, hundreds of million years ago, some ancient ancestor reached a body with both male and female systems, and since then, all his offspring are doomed to have a hermaphrodite body. Interestingly, it is not that black and white. In some specific cases, the male system can be lost. And in this case, we have only females which reproduce by mating with other individuals of the population, which still maintain male and female function. Another case of hermaphroditism is sequential hermaphroditism in groups beyond the Euthynera, and these occur mainly in groups which live very close to other animals in the marine biotope, whether as predators, as commensals, or, more importantly, as parasites. And in these, we find time and again that the male system develops first, and the small young individual functions as a male. Later on, he will function as both a male and a female. And finally, he may perhaps function only as a female. And then there is another case of dwarf males. Dwarf males are functionally hermaphrodites. We have a huge female and a tiny male attached to it. The female settles often as a parasite. And then, from the water body, it attracts, presumably by pheromones, another individual, imposes upon it to become a male. The male remains a tiny dwarf, nourished by the female, which does nothing more than fertilize her ova. Also common in the freshwater is parthenogenesis, in which one individual produces females, which will produce females without the presence and interference of a male. In oysters, Australia, the individual changes its sex every season. It begins as a male, next season it becomes a female, then it becomes a male again, then again a female. These are oysters inhabit rocky habitats of the intertidal.
My garden is full of snails. In fact, they are an invasive species and a pest. The first significant rain in the fall induces these snails to mate and lay eggs and to proliferate even more, as if there are not more than enough of them already. I moved some of them to a conical glass bowl filled with soil. Here, you can see how two snails are engaging in a many hour long reciprocal mating. Fast forward 4 hours, you can see how the left one is retracting his male sex organ out of the female sex organ of the right one. Fifteen minutes later, the right one removes his organ. After 8 days, both snails dug holes in the soil and laid each several dozen eggs. Due to the conical shape of the vessel, they reached the glass so that we could follow the eggs. After 2 weeks, small snails hatched from these eggs. Snails can be found everywhere, so you too can try to follow their mating and the eggs.